Hey everybody, Ann here, sitting inside the tiny house having my coffee because it's freezing gosh darn cold outside. Well, it was freezing inside too. 29 degrees outside, 39 degrees in the tiny house. But I got a fire going and it's like 60 some odd degrees in here now. I've done the chicken chores. I got up extra early because the puppies, they wanted to go out. And I know they want to go out because they wake up, basically. But I've been doing a few things, putting a few things up, changing some stuff, just some subtle changes inside the tiny house. So I'll show you those. And I don't know. Who knows what else? First thing I wanted to show you is this little rack up here. When Donna and her daughters came, I think it was Pamela that gave me this. And it's so funny. I'm like, I don't know how to put it on. But then I discovered these little things pop out and you just put a little screw in there. But I have a place to hang all my hats and my jackets and stuff like that. So now I just got to get some trim for the paneling. So I'm going to go look for wood for that today. And also, somebody had sent me this little rack. Now, it's really just meant to hang these things on it. But this is not cast iron. This is not going to be heavy enough to hold cast iron. This is like anodized steel, but I love cooking with that thing. So I hung that up, and it was perfect size to go in one stud here, one stud there. So I'm also going to try and find another piece of trim for the paneling over there to kind of like make it look nicer, just to kind of test my theory as to whether or not that works. But I love that, and Oh, yeah. I did have some plates and stuff up here. It probably is pretty boring for me to tell you, like, the little things, how I move it around. But I moved my plates and cups over here. I took the big round plate away. Because when you're looking at it from this way, I kind of like seeing all this. So let me show you the other side. See this here? Now, remember, this my mom sent me. And it goes great, the wicker and the wire, because I have my little room divider over there by the potty area, but it has these little hooks on it, so I just hung these up and just kind of set these up. Now, I realize every time I use these, I'm going to have to dust them off, wash them off, but that's okay. It gives a nice little place for them to kind of sit, and I like it. This shelf here has just got a bunch of junk on it, and then, of course, down here is just wood and more junk. I haven't decided what all to put there, but I just really love this top shelf. And this tablecloth right here, you guys, I was going to cut it up and do stuff with it. I am not going to cut it up. That is too nice of a tablecloth. So I've just kind of folded it creatively to cover this whole thing. You never know when I'm going to need a big tablecloth. So it's staying. I am not cutting into this because it is all nicely, you know, sewn and everything. So there is no sense in messing that up. Oh, I had two of my last lilies in there, but they're about spent now. Oh, I almost forgot to tell you. This a subscriber had sent to me, and it was actually attached to like a little tripod thing so I could light myself, but I never ended up using it. So I just put it in with this thing here, and I've used it so much the light isn't very bright, but and I can turn this any way I want. I can turn it over this way by the bed, but it lights this little desk really nicely. Oh, and I don't know if you remember this. This is one of the things I brought with me in the van, Live Simply. And the story behind this, if you followed me in my van life days, you heard the story about this. An elderly man gave me that, and it's just very special to me. It just kind of reminds me of time. You know, you never know when you're going to run out of it, so I keep that there as a reminder, and inside there's just junk stuff, you know, little trinkets and whatnot. I did decide to use this fabric. This is the tub that has a dog food in it, so I just wanted to kind of cover it up because it didn't look all that nice. But I was able to use it. It works great. Put at least Papa's food up there. And over here, I finally got my solar kind of worked out. This is the charge controller, and I've actually got it mounted on the wall now. This is still going up through the window, and eventually I'm going to take it out right through the wall once I get up the courage to actually drill a hole. And I was able to get this covered. And what I did is I had to actually use that little multi-tool, remember, that had the little tiny saw in it? Oh, puppies. I had to cut a little dip in the back so that the lid wouldn't pinch the wires, and the inverter is in here, and that's what that hooks up to. But I'm not going to put a whole lot of stuff up here. That's just my junk drawer. I have this book here because I'm always getting it out and reading it. Lena from Red Road Homestead sent me that. But it looks an awful lot better than it did. And I don't have to look at those batteries and all the wire. Oh, puppies! Goodness, they're playing. So I'm glad that I got that done. It's working. The solar's working fine. I only kept it open for as long as I did because I thought something... Puppies! Oh, my gosh. Anyhow, you get the idea. So this looks better, and that makes me happy. That makes me happy, too. I totally forgot I needed to go to Tractor Supply. Oop, Papa. To get some puppy shots and some chicken feed and some chicken corn and some other various essentials from the dollar store. Grandma Ned, I'm going to get the puppy pads with your donation and a couple other things. So, yeah, that's what I'm doing right now. What do you think, Papa? Puppies are not here. Puppies are definitely not with us. Well, we are done doing our errands. We had like 4 or 5 stops to make. Oh my gosh, I want to stop at McDonald's so bad. But nope, not in the budget. So I got to go home and I got to give some puppy some shots. I got to tell you, there's a few things in life that really make me happy. One of them is a fresh composting toilet. That has nothing to do with today, but... another thing is having enough feed for my chickens. Well, and enough food for my dogs. And I've got plenty of both of those now, thanks to 2 lovely people. One of them... Hi, Torch. Grandma Ned got my puppy pads. Yes, I did. And another, anonymous donor. She asked me not to mention her name. Sent a donation, said use it however you want. And I got some feed and some corn. I keep my feed in the back of my truck, unless I have to, pile in some people, which is rare. But the corn that I get, it is whole corn, and it's deer corn. It is the cheapest kind of corn you can get, but I like it because it's not powdery. Sometimes when I've got the scratch grains, it's mostly powder, and I don't like that. Plus, it takes the chickens longer to digest this, so I give it to them at night during the winter. Now, cracked corn during the summer, but during the winter, I give them this at night. It helps them stay warm, and they absolutely love it. And then I get this. It's, 16% producer's pride layer feed because of a lovely person. I was able to get both of these. And what else did I get? Oh! And the shots for the puppies. Yes, I got the shots for the puppies, so I don't know if I'm going to be able to film that. I'm back in the tiny house. Man, time just slipped away from me today. It's actually kind of late, so I'm not going to be able to go out and get the tree limbs. You know what? They're probably kind of wet anyhow, so it'll be better tomorrow if I collect them tomorrow and use them to trim certain seams around my wood paneling and areas. Yeah, I'm gonna start doing that because I just want to see how it's gonna look and whether or not I'm gonna like it. If not, I'm gonna have to get some real trim or something to put up there. Anyhow, the puppies did get their shots. I didn't film it. I just thought some people might find that alarming. But it's easy. You just mix the stuff. You pour the wet stuff and you put it into the dry stuff and you pull it back into the syringe. You lift up the skin on the back of their neck and just. Give them a shot, and it didn't bother either one of them, although Junior squirmed quite a bit. So I had to, actually, I only got one half of it in the first time that I grabbed him again, hold him real still, and got the rest of the shot in him. I don't like doing that, sticking twice with one needle, but I didn't have a choice. I also got a dewormer for the puppies, and they both had their dose, and they gobbled it right down because I put them in Vienna sausages. They love them. I love Vienna sausage, too. I know that sounds weird because, I don't know, maybe you think they're gross. I love them. I love them on saltine crackers. I'll just get a whole one and put it on a saltine cracker and eat it for a snack. I love them. I love them. Things are shaping up around here. Things are getting a little bit more organized. I'm creating a box that I'm going to take to a thrift store and donate of things that I don't use. But I'm kind of digging it inside here. I like being in here. I do. And it's been cold. It's going to get cold again tonight. But, Also, I had noticed that the smoke was not drying out well enough, and I've not cleaned the stovepipe out. Even though I've got the T-pipe in there and I don't have the elbow pipe anymore, I still have to go and clean it out. So I went and looked yesterday, and yeah, there was lots of creosote in there. So I think I'm going to put it on my list of things to do weekly. Just get up there, remove that little cap. It's super easy. Just shove that pipe up in there and get it all clean. Look at the top, make sure that, you know, I can see daylight through the little holes in the cap. And if not, I'll have to take the pipe down and, you know, brush those out. But that's super easy. That's what I did last night. I ended up taking the whole pipe down because I wanted to clean out the little holes at the top. And I did that. And the fire that I lit last night and this morning just went beautifully, just absolutely beautifully. And it warms up so well. In fact, it is still 63 degrees in here, and I haven't had a fire going since probably around 8 a.m., and the temperature outside, I don't know, I think it's getting close to the 40s, and it's going to drop down below freezing again tonight, so I'm just going to light another fire. Yep, cook something on the wood-burning stove. I haven't been using propane at all, which is a good thing, because I noticed the prices has gone up again at Tractor Supply Company. I think last year it was under $3. It's like almost $4 now. It's well over $3. I know that much. So I'm so glad that I haven't had to use propane. But I'm going to have to get some soon. I just couldn't get it today. Anyhow, enough blabbering for me. That's all I got for you guys today. See you in the next video. Thanks for watching, everybody. I hope you enjoyed the video. Make sure you like, subscribe, hit the bell, and y'all have a good one.